Please come.
Yes.
Please come, Mr. Reddy.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, please. Please get seated.
Thanks.
It's a pleasure to see you already in Forest Service.
Yes, sir.
Where are you posted now?
Sir, I'm presently in training, sir. Presently in training in Dehradun.
Okay.
In Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy.
Very nice.
And I was allotted Andhra Pradesh cadre, sir.
Very nice. Great cadre. So you are satisfied with that allotment of the cadre? When IAS, you may get a cadre anywhere else. So I don't think you are away from zone 1. So would you like to join IAS or?
No, sir.
Anywhere?
Sir, anywhere it is fine for me, sir.
Okay.
Because it is a pure luck that I got Andhra Pradesh cadre as my home cadre. But apart from that, I'm looking forward for better opportunities and diverse arenas where I want to work and contribute myself.
Okay.
And
so just want to sit from Dehradun to Mussoorie is very close by. Is it?
Yes.
Only 25 miles.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Tell me, you are from, you know, Mr. Chaitanya Reddy, and you are from Anandpur district. Can you compare this Sai Baba and this Chaitanya, both of them?
Yes.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Sir, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a medieval saint, sir, of Bhakti cult. And he was a disciple of Krishna. And whereas Sach Sai Baba is, he himself is pronounced as a godman, to himself. And he is multidisciplinary in nature, sir. So he accommodated Christian principles, Islam principles and Hindu principles in his teachings.
Okay.
So there is a profound difference between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sach Sai Baba, sir.
What is the Christian principle he incorporated?
Sir, love all, serve all is the motto of Sach Sai Baba, sir.
Yes.
And I think it is taken from the Bible. To so service to the mankind.
How has he implemented in practice?
Sach Sai Baba has he started many education institutions, sir, and he has provided health for free to all the people. He has started many hospitals in Puttaparthi, in Bangalore, in many other places in the country, sir. So that way he helped a lot for the service of the poor, sir. And along with it, sir, a very important initiative that he has taken in Anantapur district, providing drinking water for the drought-prone villages. So that is one of the very good initiative taken by him, sir.
Right. It seems you are very much, you know, interested in tribal land rights, tribal affairs, because there are poorest of the poor. So, how do you reconcile the opposition in the forest officers with the tribals? What is the opposition inherent in the forest officer's mind and tribals? Very awkward question I am asking.
Yes, it is a pertinent question since the colonial rule, sir. Sir, the forest department is a estate management role where the reserve forest is under its control, sir. In the same forest, tribals do also claim that the land belongs to them. So it's a tussle between the forest and tribals on the ownership of the land, sir. And whereas as a Indian Forest Act gives the forest department to have a stronghold on the area, but there are no legal provisions for the tribals to
there is a new act. Which is that act?
Sir, it is Forest Rights Act, sir. Forest Rights Act. It is scheduled tribe and the forest dwellers recognition of forest rights, sir.
Yes, they have the rights now.
Yes, sir.
So why is it not being done?
Sir, it has been widely implemented in throughout the country, sir. But there are lacunae in the implementation because the tribals are not aware of the act, sir. And second, because being illiterate, they cannot provide proper documentation for their claims of the rights.
They are not to provide because you have to study. You have to find out for how many years they have been cultivating the fringe of land or forest.
Yes, sir.
So it is upon the land revenue machinery, they have to do it. Then they have to report that. That is the whole thing. And forest officers have not to object to it.
Yes, sir.
They tell me, one thing I want to ask you very practically, because you have done some research also on this. Huh?
Yes, sir.
They are free to have the good lots free from forest. So what is the problem? Because after all, you have to clean the forest. So if they are collecting those leaves and all this, what can be the objection there by the forest populace? Because they are helping the forest. And they are the people who have guarded the forest really.
True, sir. Sir, even the acts also provide the PISA Act, the Panchayat Extension to Scheduled Area Act, and the Forest Rights Act also provide the rights over the minor forest produce. It is NTFP, sir. But I feel there is a habit for the forest officials to have the rights over the forest. That is the reason that the acts are not being implemented properly. But again, sir, the tribals also need to educate and organize themselves.
Basically, in English, secondly, yes. Sometimes when they go for, you know, these minor forest produce, they also cut the real wood.
Timber,
very costly.
Yes, sir.
They don't come, but these agents, who are there.
Yes, yes, sir.
So you have done the tribal unemployed youth counseling. So you have done a lot of counseling to that?
Yes, sir.
Whatever counseling?
Sir, when I went to many tribal villages, I found, sir, most of the tribal youth who are educated are unemployed because they lack skills. And I also saw that the government has providing lot of
employment opportunities.
Timber.
Very costly. They don't have at this age.
The help of IBD and Shari.
Yes, yes.
We have done the tribal counseling.
Sir.
And you provide data for them?
I went to many tribal villages, most of the tribal youth who are educated are unemployed because they lack skills. And I also saw that the government has providing lot of skills. Sir, that was during my graduation, sir. So whenever we have to go to our college, we have to cross the Juwari slum, sir. So there, because of the interaction with the slum dwellers, we conducted education outreach program in the schools, the primary school. That the children over there are lacking English and mathematical skills, sir. So during Sundays and Saturdays, we along with a group of friends, we used to go and teach the children. So that way, we could
interact. How did you reach for? During
graduation, sir. I done my graduation in BITS Pilani.
Pilani is different from Goa?
There is a Goa campus in
Juwari.
Goa
campus.
Yes, sir.
You are already in a All India Service group. Why do you want to sit now? And maybe this is not going to someone who needs this more. Why?
Sir, the forest, Indian Forest Service is an All India Service, sir, which provides ample opportunities to work in the field level. But I am aspiring to take up bigger challenges, and I want to work in the diverse fields which the Indian Administrative Service offers. And that was one of the reasons for attempting one more time, sir.
I heard you talking about tribal and problems.
What is the biggest problem due to urbanization on the tribal population? Sir, urbanization and industrialization are the reasons for, one of the reasons for the land alienation of the tribals, sir. For example, if you take the case of Jharkhand, the Bokaro Steel City, and even in the Bhadrachalam area, Manuguru coal thermal power plant, the urbanization is leading to the encroachment of the tribal lands. And when we convert the municipalities from the gram panchayats, the tribals are losing most of their rights because PISA cannot be implemented in municipalities.
So you think the reason for emergence of insurgency is also this? Or there is something else, different between insurgency and the region that you said, urbanization leading to tribal there. Nah, so they become anti-government.
Sir, this land alienation is most prominent reason for the insurgency that is left-wing extremism in that area, sir.
Okay. Just tell me about man-animal conflict. You are in forest service. So how do you see resolution to this man-animal?
So the forest area is being fragmented because of the human interference in the forest areas. And along with it, sir, there is growing tendency of converting the forest land into agriculture land. And there is increase in the population of wildlife also. So that is leading to the conflict between the human and wildlife, sir. Recently, as a part of introductory tour in the academy, I've been to Chandrapur region, sir. So there were almost 20 tigers in the buffer region. So where there is the constant interaction between interface between the human and the and the animal, the tiger especially. So there were also 23 deaths in that area, sir. So this can be tackled when the people were made much aware of how to deal with the animals.
Good. Last question is: tell me two biggest reforms that have been carried out during last 5 years. Who biggest
reform in India? Sir, in economic front, the introduction of GST is one of the biggest reforms, sir. And in coming to the social front, providing 10% reservation for the economically weaker sections is one more reform. So this I can see the biggest reforms in the last.
You have seen Supreme Court judgment today on reservation? The headlines?
No sir, I didn't see.
From Indian Forest Service, which is already want to shift those all India service. All India service and other group A services, because they take services to the higher pedestal. But then your choice. But I want to know whether Indian Forest Service officer can in some way help in combating insurgency.
Yes, sir. Sir, the Indian Forest Service officers work mostly in the tribal area and the most remotest parts of the country, sir. And incidentally, sir, the left-wing extremism or the Naxalism is also present in the same area, sir. One of the reason for that is the lack of livelihoods for the forest dwellers and the tribals. And by utilizing the forest resources, there is a lot of ample opportunities to provide the livelihoods for the tribals, sir. That way, once the livelihoods are secured for the tribals, I don't think they will go to the left-wing extremism, sir.
So you have opted for Indian Revenue Services, IT, but you have not opted for Indian Revenue Service Customs and Sanitation Service. Any specific reason for that?
Sir, there is no specific reason for that, sir. So, as I am already in Indian Forest Service, I do not want to choose other than the All India Services, IAS and IPS. Just to keep my options open, I put IRS, IT and Indian Audits and Account Service, sir. I do not have much information about those services right now.
So, you have done your Masters in Development Practice. What is the philosophy of development?
So the basic philosophy of development is to bring happiness for everyone on the earth, sir. So that is the core philosophy of development. So the development practice is taking the development to the undeveloped areas by way of different various techniques and again by way of bridging the gap between the developed and the underdeveloped.
What are the techniques that you use?
So one of the techniques we used is the participatory rural appraisals. And along with it, there is also theory of change, where we understand the needs of the people and try to cater it. So there is a protocol for that.
Okay. So is there any difference between development and economic growth?
Yes, sir. Sir, growth is mostly quantitative, sir, whereas development is qualitative and overall and all-round improvement of the human life. And again, sir, growth will only transform into development when the environment is taken care, sir.
Are we becoming more developed? Are we becoming more developed?
Yes, sir. We are in the process of developing.
Okay, what happens? How do you do that?
Sir, since the economic reforms of 1991, almost 22% of our population were kept out of the poverty, sir. And every year we are improving ourselves to in the reduction of poverty. That is one way of looking at it, sir. And again, the per capita income of our nation has grown since then. And we are also making strides in the environment part by various acts and by promoting the environment and the biodiversity. We are in a mood of sustainable development.
So you graduated in 2011.
Yes.
And started your master's in 2016. So can you elaborate what about those 5 years?
Sir, right after my graduation, I got an opportunity to work in a software firm, sir, for 2 years.
Okay.
Then I realized my interest is somewhere else and I wanted to take civil services. And I prepared for 6 months and I gave the attempt, sir. And later I felt I got an opportunity to work with PM's Rural Development Fellow, and I wanted to see whether I can contribute more for the society and whether I can improve more. So then I took up the opportunity, sir, and I worked there for 3 years.
So aren't you proud of being a chemical engineer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what properties help plastics resist water? Basic question of chemical.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sorry, sir.
No, see, despite the warm climate in our state, why do we find so less AC than buses?
Sir, the per capita income of our state is very less, sir, and the affordability of the people to have AC buses is low. That was the reason.
Can you elaborate why fuel prices in Poland are usually very high?
I have no idea, sir. No. Sorry. But I'll look into it, sir.
One last question. So why do we find so many residents from Andhra Pradesh? Any
sir,
general opinion?
Sir, it is to do with the political party that they belong, sir. So the Andhra Pradesh has a stronghold of Congress and it gave opportunities for them to rise. That might be one of the reasons.
About this alienation of land, can I ask them that I will tell you? This, how can the waste plastic be used? Plastic, they say, okay, you should not use the plastic.
Yes.
How can the waste plastic be used?
So, waste plastic be used?
Yes. Plastic waste.
Yes, sir. So we can have the recycling of the plastic, sir, and reuse of the plastic. And before that, we need to reduce the use of plastic, sir. So that way.
You be a chemical engineer.
Yes.
Tell it positive chemical solution, recycling or wasted. And then, how can it be also usefully used plastic?
So by reusing it in the other form.
What form?
Sir. Recently, Reliance has constructed a road.
Yes.
In Gujarat by using the plastic, sir.
Many roads have been constructed.
Many roads, yes, sir. So it will reduce the use of bituminous coal. So whereby, and also it also reduces the plastic waste and the need for recycling it. So that
can
be said.
Madras has come up with a technology which can really recycle the plastic.
Yes, I'll look into it.
Okay.
Sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.